Danny Barel, one of the founders of Moshav Chatzeva in the Central Arava, is a farmer who is also involved with tourism and works as a tourist guide. For Danny, the Arava Rift Valley provides the ideal combination of home, income, and living close to nature. Eyal, who joined us on our tour of the region, lives in Moshav Faran, the southernmost Moshav in Israel. First, a little modern history and information about this special region of the Arava. At the end of the 1950s, a group of pioneers from the various Moshavim throughout the country and soldiers from a Nachal unit of the army settled at an experimental agricultural station then called the Agricultural Observation Point and founded the first Moshav in the area, which they called Ein Yahav. Then followed the Moshavim of Chatzeva, Faran, Sofar, Idan, and the area center settlement of Sapir. At the dawn of the 21st century, there are six successful settlements in the Central Arava based on technologically advanced agriculture, well-developed public services, a dynamic and developing tourist industry, and many smaller family industries. Today, about 500 families and hundreds of additional hired agricultural workers live in this area. Sukkim is about to become the seventh settlement in the Central Arava. The success of the settlements can be attributed to the development of modern desert agriculture and to the personal courage of the settlement founders who, by hard work and perseverance, managed to farm efficiently and effectively, using the desert conditions to their advantage and proving that desert agriculture was economically viable in Israel. Market figures of national agricultural produce show that the Moshavim of the Arava are at the forefront of agricultural export, providing more than 50% of the vegetables destined for abroad. In addition, they provide more than 12% of the fresh-cut flowers grown especially for export. One of the most ancient highways in Israel crosses the Central Arava. The Old Spice Route provided places of rest for ancient travelers. Examples of such are Boa and the fortifications of Tamar at Ir Ovot. Now as then, the Old Spice Route is active and is used as a popular route for desert trips. Nature lovers enjoy the many hiking trails through the canyons and wadis, which include observation points near natural springs and water sources, and places where the desert animal life can be seen. The Moshav inhabitants developed and stimulated desert tourism, providing day activities for visitors to the area and also bed and breakfast accommodations. They introduced sites providing for alternative medicine and also specialized catering for desert expeditions and restaurants. New ideas and activities are flowering and developing alongside the agriculture of the Moshavim. The economic base for families on the Moshavim allows individual family members to develop personal interests, some of which develop to become the central business interests of the families. Among these, one can find artists, jewelry makers, potterers, sculptors, clothing designers, nurseries for house and garden plants, natural food and health products, special oils, and even an ice cream industry using camel's milk. The standard of living in the Moshavim of the Central Arava is seen as being high, with many of the Moshav members enriching their lives with different activities, courses, and hobbies. The work opportunities for women and children growing up on the Moshavim are increasing all the time. Today, one can find opportunities in the agricultural high-tech industry, an example of which is the growing of tropical ornamental fish for ponds and gardens. The Area Council Development Department is responsible for providing additional solutions and the development of many various projects. Most of the services needed by the area are to be found at Sapir, the Area Council, the Agricultural Research and Development Offices, the schools, clinic, police, and more. The transport facilities in the area are limited and principally based on privately owned vehicles and egged bus routes running between Tel Aviv and Eilat. The Area Council provides public transport services for specific purposes, such as transporting pupils to and from school, special cultural events, etc. For local residents, there's a round-trip flight to Tel Aviv every day. Under the auspices of the Jewish Agency, a project called Partnership 2000 has created ties between the communities of the Arava and Jewish communities in Australia. Partnership 2000 supports many cultural and communal activities and promotes the exchange of youth groups between the Arava and Australia. In the framework of cultural life for the region, the Area Council provides various courses bringing teachers from the center of the country on a weekly basis for folk dancing, ballroom dancing, special shows, Jewish holiday presentations, and performances and traditional events not provided by the communities themselves. Youth activities outside the school take place in each settlement with the support of the Area Council's Youth and Sports Department and under the guidance of the National Youth Movement. Nightlife in the settlements is centered around the family unit, but most places have their local pubs or clubs used as social meeting places. One of the most amazing experiences for the traveler in the Arava is to see the flash floods in the desert. The inhabitants of the Arava have seen their settlements isolated at the time of the rains. In many cases, no vehicles could reach them for hours, and in some cases, there was danger to life and limb and serious damage to agriculture and property. There doesn't appear to be another example like this in existence today. Pioneers proving that over the years and the generations, it is possible to change the harsh environment into a home and an oasis of greenery, which has succeeded economically and socially. So, now that you know us a little better, Danny, Eyal, and indeed all of us, invite you to see with your own eyes the wonderful treasures of the Central Arava. See you soon!